In 2013 and 2014, the department initiated some emergency welfare intervention actions to prevent the suffering of starving koalas here at Cape Otway. Some of the trees have shown signs of recovery, but koala densities are still high, and the department needs to maintain proactive management of the area just to protect the koala welfare and the habitat. So our focus this week is to collect a representative sample of koalas from across Cape Otway. We're focusing our attention on private land in Cape Otway, where koalas are most affected by overbrowsing in manna gums, which is their favoured food source. The health assessment is expected to run for a week. It involves catching the koalas, examining them, assessing their health, ear tagging them, and implanting the females with fertility control prior to release. We'll be catching them using qualified catchers and assessing them with qualified veterinarians according to strict health protocols. Any unhealthy koalas that are deemed too sick to survive release will be euthanised humanely to prevent further suffering. So following the health assessment, the department will be conducting habitat mapping and species distribution modelling, and all of this information will be used to guide future management actions. This health assessment is the first action out of recommendations that were made to the Minister for Environment and Climate Change by an expert panel. Koala welfare and habitat health continue to be our top priorities, and we're working with landholders and partner agencies to ensure that the situation improves at Cape Otway.